So in this video now, we're going to talk some about the general elution problem in gas chromatography, right? Remember that in gas chromatography, solutes separate primarily based on boiling point. Where if you have a compound with high intermolecular force strength, then it has a higher boiling point or a lower volatility, and it will have a later retention time, okay? Or it remains in the condensed phase on the stationary phase and will not elute from the column until that column is heated up to a higher temperature. So what's carrying the solutes that are gaseous through the column is a mobile phase that is a gas. It's known as a carrier gas. And the carrier gas needs to have a very low boiling point. It needs to be a gas at room temperature, of course, much lower than any of the solutes that are being eluted from the column. So some common carrier gases include nitrogen. You can also use things like argon, a noble gas, helium, and hydrogen. Hydrogen's a bit reactive. Sometimes you use a mixture of these. Nitrogen, argon, and helium are super stable and unreactive. But these are all common carrier gases. What we do not use is oxygen, unless it's a small percentage just in air, because oxygen is reactive. It's a very strong oxidizing agent, and it's reactive and super explosive in the form of singlet oxygen. So in GC, a general elution problem can arise as well, where if you have your carrier gas come out at the first peak, that's the mobile phase, and then you might have some other compound, let's say we have hydrocarbon pentane come out at an early time, and then we have to wait a long time for these other hydrocarbons, C8, which is octane, and then eventually C10, which is decane. So the compound that is heaviest in molar mass here has the highest boiling point due to London dispersion force strength, or it's least volatile. And the lowest boiling point compound was pentane that came out first. So the general elution problem, right, is picking a temperature, okay, and at that constant temperature, ensuring that the compounds separate with good resolution, but we also don't have some huge inefficient lag. So at constant temperature, we usually see this inefficient wait time. I'm showing that here. We have to wait a long time between when pentane and octane elute. So we would like to make the separation more efficient or not have to wait all day for the later or heavier hydrocarbons to elute. We'd like to bring those peaks closer to TM without messing up the resolution. So the solution to doing this, or to getting a chromatogram where we efficiently collect the data in a reasonable time, but also with high resolution, is temperature programming. So knowing the boiling points of your solutes, you can program the temperature to go through a steady increase in temperature values as the separation proceeds. So you set the machine to do some constant ramp rate. Maybe it'll increase by 10 degrees for every 2 minutes or something. And the mobile phase of the carrier gas still comes out first. Pentane, low boiling point, is eluted next. But now these two peaks are going to move to the left, because after pentane elutes, right, in this period here, we're going to increase the temperature, or it's going up at a constant ramp rate. And that's going to cause octane to boil off the column, enter the mobile phase and elute quicker. And under the same idea, you'd increase the temperature again, so that decane, the heaviest, highest boiling point hydrocarbon here, elutes last. So we still have good resolution, peaks are still well separated, but we don't have to wait this long efficient time. So you steadily just increase the temperature to pull off or elute the higher boiling point compounds as the separation proceeds. So just know that a second way to do this that's less common is pressure programming. Right. You can alter the pressure inside of the column. If that decreases, then that will allow gas molecules to evaporate, and then that will cause them to elute from the column and decrease the retention time. Okay, but the more common way for sure is doing the steady increase in temperature or temperature programming. So for more practice with gas chromatography and the general elution problem for both GC and LC, you can visit Unit 2 of my analytical course guide at chemguides.com.